Hey everyone, 6'8" guy. I'm here to show some more recent purchases I've made in the past few weeks. As you can see, I've been stocking up here on some, I think, pretty good deals, which I'll share with you here in a second. I'll start off by starting here with the Winchester's 115 grain 9mm. These were sort of on sale. I mean, they're $25. Normally they're more than that. I bought these at Gander Mountain just because I had a $40 off coupon from the prior month's credit card statement. So two of these, minus the $40, I only paid 13 something for the both of them with taxes. So I figured, why not use it? Or if I don't use a coupon, I'll lose it. So I used it. Went to Dick's Sporting Goods. They had some sale going on with their Winchesters, and this was, as you can tell, 12 gauge, 2¾ inch. These are 6 sled shots. Normally at like a Walmart, they're like almost $23 for a box of 100. These were maybe a dollar, or a little over a dollar less. And usually, like I said, since these were the 6 shots, for being a little cheaper, I bought a box. Why not? Because hopefully then by spring I'll have my dad's shotgun back, since from my previous video I got the barrel and I'll be dropping it off today to have him repair it. So hopefully I'll be able to shoot with my new clay pigeon also. So anyways, moving on. When I was in West Virginia with down Gander Mountain, I bought these CCIs, their AR Tactical 22 round nose, 1200 foot per second, 40 grain. There's 375 rounds a box. They were 1875, I think, a box. Cheap as I've ever found them. Even online, they're a lot more. Because normally I think it was almost like $95 for a box of 4, which comes out to, you know, not quite $25 a box. So got these while I was down there. Plus, for my previous video, I showed you a box of that. I can't remember now. But anyways, moving on. Watching a loan company video where he's been stocking up on these Seller and Bellet ammo. It's 9mm, 115 grain. I bought some of these about a month ago. They were $9.99. They actually dropped the price again to $9.79. So I figured with free shipping, I really got credit back because I got $20 card or a credit, and my shipping was less than that, and no taxes. I bought 10 more boxes. Also bought a pair of winter boots. I think they were Columbia's. They were half off, so which I won't really show those. But between me and my son I think is almost the foot size of my feet. I think they're pretty close to a size 13. So between the two of us, we'll be using those boots. And then the rest of these orders. Finally placed my first order at Cheaper Than Dirt. You know, I've been having I find stuff, put them in a cart, been holding there for a while, and like, you know, one time they're out of stock, so I'll wait until other stuff come back. But long story short, this is what I purchased. I already bought a bottle of hot beans. This is a quart, 32 ounce from Cabela, but this is actually cheaper. This is $13.03, but with shipping, you know, it probably was another dollar more, but still a lot cheaper than anywhere else, retail or Cabela. So I figured, well, I'll go get a second bottle, because like the small 2-ounce bottle that I had for my dad that was at least 25 years old, it's still working. So I still have a little bit left. That's why I bought the one from Cabela, and then I said I just bought this one for Cheaper Than Dirt. So I'll be using this to clean my guns and rifles and shotguns. So now, as you can see, I purchased half a dozen of my dad's deer rifle. The top one is the 3040 Craig, 180 grain Remington. I only have a box of reload I bought at a gun show, and another box, I think, Winchester's at one of the local gun stores. So all these prices are cheaper than anywhere. I mean, anywhere from the most expensive might have been $26, $28, in between $26 and $28. And as you can see, the other boxes are the 300 Savage, anywhere from 150 grain to 180 grain, between the Remington, the Federals, and the Winchesters. So I figure between these boxes and the few that I already bought last year, I will use these shells to hopefully start doing reloading in the future. Either use my neighbors or eventually buy my own. But anyway, I think this is a good enough ammo. I won't be shooting these deer rifles much, but I figured for the price, they're the cheapest anywhere. And I could have bought some other ones, but they were from another warehouse that's cheaper than dirt, so I figured maybe down the road. I think those were reload ammos too. I can't remember the name of the top. But those prices for the 300 Savage was like $19.99 up to $25.50 or whatever, $26 depending what grain. So I'll be purchasing probably another order from warehouse. This is from warehouse B. And the other stuff I have maybe from, I don't know, in 6 months will be from warehouse A. And I guess I just added a new warehouse D. I mean, they have A, B, and C. And then I just noticed after New Year they added a warehouse D. So, but from each warehouse, if you have stuff in there, they'll charge you shipping from each warehouse. So I figure I'll just buy one order from one warehouse this time and buy another one from the next warehouse as I figure out which, you know, accumulate which is the next largest amount of ammo that I will purchase from and do it in the future. As you can see, I've bought some more 9mm, 115 grain, between some steel casings to brass casings, you know, MFS, Remingtons, a couple different variations of Remingtons. Hopefully I can see it. And Fahuchi, to be honest, I haven't really heard anybody pronounce this, so hopefully I'm not butchering it. I think it's Italian, Italy, who knows, it sounds Italian. And of course, another box of Winchesters. And then I went to, they're all 9mm, 124 green, some more Seller and Bellet, BMT Bronze, another two more boxes of different Remingtons, and then Independence, which I think is considered like their, it's a blue box, but they call it the white box, CCIs. And then I bought two boxes of 147 grains, American Eagle and Remington. And then this other one's 158 grain, which is the largest I've ever seen. And like I told you, one of my other videos, I bought a reload that I think was about 159 grain, but it gave me problems. Hopefully this doesn't give me a problem. This is a round though, where the other one was more of a flathead. Anyways, and then I bought a couple of boxes of 410 shotgun ammo. As you can see, Fucci, I don't know, Winchesters and Federals. And then I bought a few boxes of 22 round those, you know, Thunderbolts, which we had success for my son's semi 22, American Eagle, which we had some success, and I never had these Federals, so I figured, for the price, buy them, experiment. Probably won't buy too much 22 ammo from Federal or from cheaper than dirt. And then stocked up on some boar. Have these boar snakes. Got the 12 gauge. Got the 410. This is for the 300 Savage and 3040 Krag. This is the 22 caliber, and then the 9mm, which I have, or the 357 caliber. So for the price, these were the cheapest I found anyway, even cheaper than Walmart. And even with a little bit of a, I don't think these, since these light, are weighed so light, there wasn't much of a shipping difference. It kind of played around with the cart. So anyways, my phone's ringing. I'm going to answer it. But I do want to show you another purchase that my family got me for Christmas. All right? Here's what my family got me. My first gun safe. Got this at Cabela's when we were down there on Christmas Eve. They surprised me and said, hey, we want to get you a gun safe. I was like, really? Because I was looking at some of those smaller ones, like the whole couple, you know, handguns by the bed. But this is in our bedroom. It holds, it's a 14 gun. I like it. There's some light in here because, you know, I keep my my Smith & Wesson, my carry, my extra mags, my extra ammo, and then my Sigma. Smith & Wesson, more of a, my wife, if something ever happens when I'm home at home, she can use it, it's loaded. And extra accessories, my Sparco knife, earplugs, mag, fast loader, my extra knives that I bought. Some of these in the back are the ones for the contest that I'll be giving away. Of course, that one I'm not giving away is my Gerber Gator 2 and the Bear. But the other knives, and I might throw in some, like maybe this Storm 2 that I've bought, and some, maybe some pocket knives as options to for the winners to get. But you know, I like to get another second shelf. I'm trying to look online if anybody knows where I can get. I'd like to put a second shelf right above this stuff to, you know, kind of get a little more organized. I'm wasting space up here. Haven't had any success trying to find extra shelf for a century. And down here, of course, my dad's 22, pump, Remington, two deer rifles, the 3040 Springfield Armory, Craig. Of course, the 410 shotgun, the 300 Savage, and a couple flashlights. Here's my knife case, all my knives have been showing. Then the recent knife I bought, the Browning Special Edition, and my first gun case box. And there's my keychain that I won from, drawing a blank. He's a, something, not Hitchcock, that's the current 45. Oh, 2009, I'm drawing a blank. But anyway, I'll append, of course, the link in the video. And like I said, eventually once I get my 12-gauge shotgun, it'll go in here. I mean, it's not as roomy. I mean, it's all right. I don't have many weapons, but this is it. You know, you can put them on the sides. And like I said, I know I heard people said with scopes, it takes a little more room, which is true. Since the 22 has a scope and the 300 Savage has a scope. So, but for the time being, this will do. Like I said, if I get the second shell, move all this up above the second layer. But this is what I got. It's a first start. I've seen, you know, I know there's better safes out there for those who have an armory of weapons. But for me, this is a good start. Maybe down the road, maybe I'll give this gun safe to my son and get a bigger one down the road. And I'm going to show you my dad's gun safe. And the reason why I've been kind of looking to replace it. Not replace it, I'm keeping it. My son would be using that for his personal, where his 22 is stored. Maybe other future weapons we'll put in there that we're not overly worried about being stolen because it's in a wooden glass case cabinet. But I'm never going to get rid of it because it was my dad's. And that's something, everything about my dad's I'm keeping and cherish. So this is what I get for Christmas. Also, of course, I'm storing some stuff up here. Forgot to mention this. Purchased the new edition 2012 Standard Collection Firearms. Ordered this back in October at Amazon. It finally came, I think, right before Christmas. And originally it was 26 something, and then about a few weeks before I was gonna get it, they had this deal, the price lowers, you get it at that price. This was like 19 something. So I always wanted to get this. I knew a 2011 was out there. I knew 2012 would be coming out in December, so I figured I'd order it to get an idea of all the different firearms and the prices and nice little catalog. So I'm glad I got it. Hey everyone, I just wanted to show you how much I packed this ammo can full of 9mm. This is all of my 115 grain. I started a second container over there, but that has the rest of 115. Then I had the 147, 158 grain. But I just wanted to weigh this and see how much this thing is heavy. I know this thing's only made to hold
so much weight.
Hold on, I gotta activate the scale. Let's see. Let me turn the sound up.
Hello.
Here we go.
I'm ready.
She's ready, guys.
Alright.
Let's see how much this bad boy weighs.
75.4 pounds.
I think this is the heaviest box I got, and I'm about to show you. Goodbye. I'm about to show you the other ammo. Talk to you. Alright everyone, here is my dad's gun cabinet. This currently, in the past, held all his rifles and shotguns. Now as you can see, it's now just holding my son's 22. And if we ever get any additional 22, we'll probably stick it in there. You know, the lesser expensive ammo, not ammo, but weapons will stick in here. But anyway, I just wanted to show off, not show off, but show the ammo cans that I had bought from Cabela for $3.75 a box. And the bottom two are, well, the bottom one is my XS 22 ammo. The next two boxes are my shotgun ammo. The next two are my 9mm, and the top one is my dad's deer rifles with 300 Savage and 3040, which isn't, 3/4, maybe a half full. But the one, as you know, you saw the video how much it weighed, the one with the red lock. And then the one above it's the higher green ammo, and like I said, the two shotgun boxes are pretty full. Hopefully this summer or the spring we'll start shooting clays. And then these are pretty much just couple of them are empty. A couple of them have the gifts for my contest. Some are supplies in the sense of, ear muffs, ear protection. There are NASCAR ones, but we stick them in there. And Target stuff that I won. I also have a box full of my knife box that I keep and some other miscellaneous things. I'm trying to remember. Of course, here's the box my son made when he was in Scouts. This is where I keep all my cleaning supplies. And then this is an extra box of those pink shotgun shells. And then this is also a can I got from Cabela. This is where all the 22 shells that we use, we go out shooting with the 22. This is the open boxes of all the ammo that we are currently using.